about their achievements. They boast about everything that they have. They have money, they have car, they have plane, they have good houses, they eat good food, they don't like anything in their account. But when God look at them with the eyes of salvation, he said that you are naked, you are wretched. It means that something that you don't have is that you will never have peace. You will never have joy. You will never have real love. Those are things that your money of sin cannot buy. Sin can give you everything that you want in this world, but sin will never give you the love, the peace, the joy that you are looking for. Those things, you can only get it when you have the voice of God. When you are in Christ, you can enjoy what I call true peace. There is a voice speaking to us. It's the voice of deception. It's the voice of evil spelling. It's the voice that is telling you that you can do anything. There is nothing bad in what you are doing. You can kill. You can destroy. You can speak evil. You can speak filthy words. You can even speak against God. Nothing will happen to you. But let me tell you, my brother, my sister, when that spell will fall and your eyes will open, you will know that anyone that speaks against God will never go unpunished. There is a time where the spell stops. There is a time where incantation stops. There is a time where your eyes will be open and you will realize that the things you are doing, they are not even equal to what the Lord Almighty can do for you. The Bible says that Paul, who was called Saul, became blind. He became blind because he could not face the reality. He was a man that was living a life of deception. He was a man that was living a life of spell. But when the spell fell, the Bible said that he was blind. He could not see the light. He could not walk anymore. They have to carry him. They have to take him shamefully into the city. And when he entered the city, the Bible said for 3 days, he prayed and fasted. I pray for you, my brother, my sister, that through your prayer and your fasting, the Lord will visit you and the Lord will change your life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any voice of sin that has been affecting your life after these 21 days where we have been, I believe that the Lord is going to restore your life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The voice of sin, my brother, my sister, is the voice of witchcraft. It's a powerful voice that we always push you to destroy everything. There are some people, anything they hold into their hands will be destroyed. There are people, no matter what you give them, no matter what they hold with their hands, it's always destruction. You give them a car, after one day you go to see the car, you even regretted to buy the car for them. There are some people, they entered into marriage. 3 months of marriage is too much. The marriage will collapse. Why? Because there is an evil voice speaking in their life. And that voice is the voice of witchcraft. Witchcraft is not only about going around and killing people. But witchcraft is even when you destroy your own life with your own hands, is witchcraft. Many of us, my brother, my sister, how many times we have destroyed opportunity, we have destroyed circumstances that God has prepared for us. Many of us, we have destroyed relations that God has made available for us. Many of us, wherever we are, there must always be a problem. We always bring a problem. We always bring something that will pain the life of people. The Bible says that is the voice, that is the indication that there is a voice, and that voice is not the voice of God, it's the voice of sin. Am I talking to someone? When you realize that everywhere you are a troublemaker. Wherever you go, there must always be quarrel. Wherever you are, there must be people crying, people in sorrow, people regretting to know you, why they have met you. There are people that anytime, wherever you are, whatever they give you, they will never see the product, they will never see the product, they will never see interest. My brother, my sister, that is what I call the voice of witchcraft. That destroy everything that is around you. Your own children, your own husband, your own wife, your own education. You have the opportunity to go to university. But you go to university, instead of learning, you go to enter into cult. You go to enter into mafia. You go to start taking drugs. You start loving girl. You impregnated a woman. You have to run away from that university. You go to another one, you impregnated again. Anywhere you go to study, instead of finishing your school, you finish by impregnated a woman and you run. My brother, my sister, that is the voice of witchcraft. Is the voice, that is why Jesus said it is finished. If there is a voice of witchcraft that is speaking against your life, today Jesus said it is finished.
Amen.
It is finished.
Amen.
It is finished. It is finished. It is finished. It's not because Jesus died. No, it is finished because now the assignment of God can take place into your life. It is finished. It means I have done now something that can be accomplished in your life, and the devil cannot reverse it. Am I talking to someone? If God changed your life, the devil cannot come and rechange your life. Am I talking to someone?
Amen.
I've never seen someone that Jesus, in his ministry, healing people, setting people free. There is no passage in the Bible when someone come back and say, you know the spirit that you cast away is back now. I've never read it. I don't know if you have a passage to show me. Jesus cast away a demon and the demon came back again. No. Why? Because he said, it is finished. If you have faith, if you can hold on that word, if you can walk with that faith, if you can follow him faithfully, you will not have anything that will disturb your life again. The voice of sin. I said the voice of sin is the voice of disturbance. Anytime you are somewhere, there are some people that will tell you, I can hear a voice. I can hear a voice. Voice speaking to me. Voice of distraction. You can never be in a place and you are concentrated on one occupation. One thing. No. I know some people, they can do five things at the same time. And at the end, they don't have anything to present. You have a deadline in life. You have a deadline in everything. There is not that you have all the time in the world. No, life is not all the time. Life is a process. Life is timing. Life have a season. There are seasons in life. You were born, you grow up, you start growing and so on. You were younger, you become old. So don't think that there are some, my goodness, there are some men, 50 years. But if you see them dressing like 15, they don't have the notion of time. They don't think that their life remain only perhaps 20 years. They don't calculate. They don't live according to their size. That is the spirit of disturbance. It's a spirit that will make you think that you still have time. So you can do many things at the same time. There are things that I cannot do now. I was doing it before. I can't do it now. It's impossible. It's no more my timing. It's no more in my program. I don't know if you understand me. There are things I was doing before. I was playing football. I can't play football again like I was playing before. I don't have the break to go and play like I was playing 99 minutes. No. I will play only 20, 45 minutes. It's okay. I can't go more than that. It's to kill myself. Am I talking to someone? Take things according to your size. The spirit of disturbance will tell you, you still have time. Oh no, you still have time. You still have time. There is no more time. The Bible says, redeem the time. Redeem the time, because the days are evil. You don't have time, my brother, my sister. Stopping parade as if you have time. There is no time. What you have to do today, the Bible says, don't push your assignment of today for tomorrow. And don't accumulate assignment. I'm in university, and I know what is it. When you say, I have time, you have one assignment waiting for you. And you say, I have time. Oh, leave it. I have time. Second one, I have time. Before you realize it, the time now is so short, and now you are running to finish everything. That is what I call the spirit of disturbance. Jesus said, it is finished. If that spirit has been disturbing you in this conference, in this festival, that spirit will go in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There are people, they have so many ideas. They have so many plans. Eh? You have so many things. In 1 year, you have 10 things you want to do. Which one are you going to do? Show at least one. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
The Bible says a true man, a true man, a man that loves God, is a consistent man. He's consistent in what he's doing. What he's doing is doing it with all his heart, with all his mind, with all his thought. He walks in that things. He puts all his mind on it. That's why the Bible says, even loving God, you have to love God with all your heart, with all your might, with all your... Even God wants you to be concentrated. Am I talking to someone? Be concentrated. The voice of disturbance is the voice of sin. The voice of disturbance is the voice of sin. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
A man or a woman who has attained the age of 35 or 40 cannot start playing with church. You can play with church when you are still 10 and 25. But the moment you start going 30, choice for you is limited. Take the things that you see. That is life. That is how God created us. The spirit of disturbance will make you think that you have all the privilege that when you were 50, when you were 20, when you were 10. No, it's not the same. It's different. Can somebody shout hallelujah? Life is about consistency. When God gives you something, go with it with all your heart. Commit yourself into it. Do it with strength. Do it with love. Do it with passion. And you will see how the Lord is going to reward you. Can somebody shout hallelujah? The next spirit that comes with the spirit or the voice of sin is what I call the voice of manipulation. The voice of manipulation. The voice of manipulation is a voice that will never allow you will never allow you one day to go straight. You will never be straightful. No. The best way for you to do things is to go by the corner ways. Never straightful. Always trying to make your way by the corner. That is the spirit of manipulation. When you found in your life that the easiest thing that you can get by going straight to the point, but you have to create a story before you get it. That is the spirit of sin. That is the voice of sin. It will give you ideas how you can create a story, and everybody will fall under the story. And everybody will say, hey, are you? It's like when I was watching a movie, a woman, she dressed like a banker. And she took a picture. The picture of her nephew went to a very nice institution bank, stood there, and she was crying. So when those bankers were coming out, they would think that it's one of them, because there are so many. What is the problem? Oh, it's my nephew. He has a hole in his heart. And the money they're asking is 5 million. Where can I get that money? Oh, I need money. Oh. And someone will say, okay, I don't have 5 million, but I have 100, I have 10,000 pounds. Can I give you? Oh, thank you very much. Oh, God bless you. And so on. He was manipulating people with a picture of his nephew that is in a good health, just because she wanted money. She wanted money. And finally, they caught up. And even the little money she got, they took everything. When you are a manipulator, my brother, my sister, one day they will catch you. And the little that you have, they will take it away. Be straightful. to the point. People that have manipulated their way to power. People that have manipulated their way to marriage. People that have manipulated their way to the position where they are today. After some times, when now God decides to deal with them, their shame is even worse than someone that is naked. Stop manipulating people. Stop manipulating situations. But in this world, everything is manipulable. We manipulate everything. We manipulate everybody. And we are happy because it's working. But remember, what you are using is the voice of sin. That's why Jesus said, it is finished. You can say no to that voice. You can stop manipulating your way. You can work hard and reach that level. You can be honest and achieve your life. You can be honest and get what you want in life. You can be sincere with people when you have a problem and they can help you. You don't need to lie. You need to deceive them. You need to manipulate. Am I talking to someone? The Bible says, Jesus said, it is finished. Because that spirit has destroyed many homes. That spirit has destroyed many lives. That spirit has taken away many people that were talented. That spirit have removed many people from the place of position. We have seen some pastor because they want to see the crowd. They want to see people. They want to have everything. They want to have the glory. They bury, they do incantation, and they come and they bury those things in their churches. How many stories we have in the newspapers? You see a pastor going to a herbalist. Someone that you have to convert to Jesus. And you are going there, he converts you to the devil. And gives you power. And that is the power you are using to manipulate people so that they can give you money, they can buy houses for you, you can travel first class, you can get the nice clothes, they can call you man of God, because you don't want people to call you man of the devil. So you want to cover it, be called man of God. But the work you are doing is the work of the devil. Bible says many of you will be clothed as a sheep. But what is inside? It's a wolf. There are many people. There are many churches. There are many pastors. You see them up, glorious. But when God deal with them, and God deal with the power of manipulation, those people, they are naked. That's why the Bible says in the book of Revelation, you think you are rich? You think that you have everything? You say that I can afford everything. But when I look at you, I see you are wretched. I see you are poor. I see you miserable. That is how God sees us when we try to use the voice of sin to reach the place that we are envying, the place that we desire according to our flesh. My brother, my sister, we need to understand that Jesus died to deal and to make powerless that voice. And you can say no. That's why the Bible says, therefore, there is no more condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. You can tell that voice, enough is enough. I don't want to serve you. I don't want to be your slave. I don't want to be your prisoner. I don't want to be a wretched person. I don't want to be a victim of circumstances, a victim of calamity. I don't want to be what I'm made today. I want to be free. And that freedom can only come when you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. When you accept the voice of Jesus, when he said, it is finished. That's what I said. It's not just finished because he's dead. No, finished because it's a new beginning for you. Take that new beginning. Build your life upon that voice. Build your life upon that voice. It is finished. I can start again. I can renew my life. I can restore my life. I can rebuild my life. I can become someone. Someone different of what I have been yesterday. Yesterday I was bad. I want to be good. Yesterday I was evil. I want to be righteous. Yesterday I was holy. I want to be holy. Yesterday I was someone of wickedness. I want to be someone of righteousness. You can change it because Jesus said it is finished. It is finished. It is finished. It's your choice. It's your choice to say, Jesus, I'm ready to change. I'm ready to go into what you have done for me. Can somebody shout hallelujah? Hallelujah. So tonight, my brother, my sister, I just want you to bow your head, because tomorrow we are going to say the power that Jesus has given us to be able to stand our ground and to go for the best, to go for the wonderful, to stand with a new voice. But tonight I want you to say, the voice of sin, I don't want to follow it anymore. The voice of sin, I don't want to be victim of it anymore. You have the right to say no, because Jesus said, it is finished. I want you to bow your head and say, Lord, today, I want you to take me away. I want to say no to the voice of evil. The voice that give my mind evil thoughts, evil idea, evil word. When I talk, everything in me is evil. My mind is filled with evil thoughts. There are people, they don't have any good thought. When they see anybody, they will always think the bad things that you can't even imagine. They never think good about anybody. They never imagine that people can be good in this world. No, they think that everybody are wicked. Their thought is evil, my brother and sister. Because it's not true. There are people are good. There are people are noble. There are people are worthy. There are people you can testify. God has blessed their life. And God has made them to be a reference to our generation. So I want you to pray to say, God, that voice of sin, please take it away. Take it away. That voice has been speaking to me for so many years. The voice of evil. The voice of rebellion. Telling me to rebel against you. To rebel against your words. Don't read the word of God. Don't follow God. Don't follow the instruction of God. Don't follow the vision of God. God has given you an assignment. You are not ready to do it. You refuse the assignment. The Holy Spirit is telling you, repent. You say, no, I will not repent. God is telling you, come to me. I want to change your life. You say, no, I don't want. I'm okay where I am. That voice of rebellion. Say, God, forgive me. God, take it away. I don't want to listen to it anymore. Remember that voice of sin brought us where we are today. We lost the Garden of Eden. We lost our place of dominion. We lost our place of communion with God. We lost our place of fellowship. We lost our place of unity marriage. We lost our place of fruitfulness. We lost our place of happiness. We lost our place of power and riches. Brother, my sister, do not allow that voice to continue in your life. Say, Lord, take that voice away. You said it is finished. I want that voice today to be finished. The voice of lies, the voice of deception, the voice of demonic incantation, the voice of evil spelling, the voice of witchcraft, the voice of disturbance, and the voice of manipulation. Open your mouth and pray, my brother, my sister.